Jose Clemente Orozco was an amazing Mexican muralist. He captured the struggles of different political topics in his work very well, and ever since being assigned this by my teacher, I've grown to really enjoy analyzing parts of his work, and just kind of getting really down to the details, if you will. Jose was born back in 1883. He grew up among four brothers, and was born in the southwestern part of Jalisco in Mexico. His father owned a number of factories producing soap, ink, and providing coloring services. Additionally, his father was also an editor for a local newspaper, so he was always really busy. Jose grew up at a time where it was pretty much ideal for a person like him to develop an artistic interest. However, at the time, with the way the economy was going, it was best for him to study architectural engineering as a means of making sure his family had a solid source of income in the future. And with that said, and now that you know a bunch about Jose as a whole, let's go into some of the works that I found really, really interesting and really fun to look into. This piece by Jose reorients the story of the Epic of America from the standard U.S. narrative that begins with British colonization along the northeastern seaboard, but over time it rhetorically proceeds west, where it turns into a Mexican story rooted in Mesoamerican civilizations and the devastation that they had to go through, which was brought by the Spanish conquest. Orozco presents America's epic as a cyclical in nature, the eternal return of destruction and creation, rather than a linear tale of democratic expansion and progress. This is the second of Jose's works that I will get into here. Made in June of 1930, Orozco completed his first commissioned mural in the United States, located at Pomona College in California. He was paid to paint the mural in Ferry Hall at the encouragement of Jose Pion. He was a professor of Hispanic civilization, art, and history. He painted this beautiful mural over the time period of 2 months, and it depicts the Greek myth of Prometheus, who stole fire from Mount Olympus and giving it to humanity. The main part of this mural shows Prometheus reaching for fire, preparing to give it to Earth, and the ceiling panel above it contains stylized frames emerging from composition of geometric forms. These are seen as symbolic and can be seen as Mount Olympus and its occupants staring down at Prometheus, frowning upon him. Last but certainly not least, we have the dive bomber and tank made by Orozco in 1940. There is a distinct lack of information about this that I could find through my research, but the piece itself is still readily available online. This painting is a great representation of mechanical warfare in the sense that a tank operator is sort of a sitting duck in a sense. We can see clunks of metal spread across the ground in a very abstract form, as with the rest of the piece itself. We also can observe chains holding down this metal with a pair of legs sticking out of the tank itself. From this, we can observe that the tank operator feels really, really contained to the small position where this is the only connection they have with the outside world, where all they can think about is battle and nothing else. We can also observe the tail wings of a dive bomber seen above the tank, and from this we can kind of take out that the dive bomber is on its way to destroy the tanks as a form of anti-tank measure, and this kind of puts the operator in a very simple position. The only thing they fear is air support, and it kind of presents the horrors of war in a very abstract way, and that's one of my favorite parts about this piece. With that said, I seriously believe that Jose Clemente Orozco was a great artist who captured politics very well in their work. Thank you for listening, and have a great rest of your day. Goodbye.